Hi there. Today we're going to take a look at LinkedIn's notification settings, and I'm going to do that through the LinkedIn mobile app on iOS. I'll start by going to my profile page and in the top right corner tapping on the cog icon. Okay, that will take us into the main settings screen, and then from there we need to tap the communications tab and then notifications. That takes us to the three notification tabs: email, push, and on LinkedIn. So the first of those tabs is email, and that's what we're going to look at first. I'll start with invitations and messages, and this is about the emails that you receive when people invite you to connect or to join a group, or if they've accepted an invitation to connect, or if they've sent you a direct message, or if they've sent you an email and other profiles sent to you. I don't find any of these email notifications useful, so I've turned them all off. Okay, I'm going to go back and select jobs and opportunities, which is the next section. Again, I've turned everything else off here because I'm not looking for a job, but if you are, then you might find some of these notifications interesting. You'll be alerted about jobs via email, referrals, suggestions from connections, saved job reminders, and things like that. As I say, I'm not particularly interested in any of those things, so I've turned them off. If you want to see what they look like when they're turned on, you can tap the option at the top and turn them all on in one go. So just tap that very top slider and you'll see that they all turn on, and it auto saves as well. I'm not, so I'm going to turn those back off. And again, it'll save those changes. If I want to turn on individual ones, I can do so below. Okay, the next section is called activity in your network. So you can receive emails if you want about updates in your network, and also connections in the news and suggested connections. I think all of these are a little bit spammy. You can even select when new contacts join LinkedIn. I'm just not bothered about receiving emails about those things, so I've turned that off. The next section is activity that involves you. So if you receive an endorsement, then you can receive an email about that. If there's general activity on your profile, people looking at your profile, or if you've been mentioned in media, it will tell you about that. If you receive comments on your updates, if you're not a regular LinkedIn user, that might be a useful feature. But again, I don't tend to use email notifications, so I've turned those things off. Okay, news and articles is next. This is possibly the most spammy of all of these. In this section, LinkedIn highlights and ideas on what to write. No, thank you very much. I'm going to skip the bit about updates from your groups because that contains some of my own personal groups. I'll move on to offers and tips from LinkedIn. Again, I've turned all of these off. If you're just getting started, you might want to turn some of them on. Okay, so that's the email section done. I'm going to move on to the push tab now, which is the notifications you get in the app. And I find these a lot more interesting. You can see that I've turned some of these on. And I'm going to get started with the invitations and messages section. Okay, the first section is called invitations and messages. And here I've turned on sends you a message. So if someone direct messages me, my LinkedIn app on my iPhone desktop will have the red one on there just to show that I've received a message. I've turned it off for invites you to connect and accepts your invitation because I don't think those things need to send a notification. So if I go into the app themselves, I'll still see the notifications at the bottom of the screen within the app, but from my phone desktop, I won't. The next section is jobs and opportunities. Again, if you're a job seeker, you'll probably want these things turned on. I'm not particularly bothered. I could easily have turned these options off. Next is activity in your network. I think most of these things are pointless, but if you're interested in engagement, you know, people liking and commenting on your content, then I would very much leave the last option, shares or engages with a topic, turned on. There's only one option in news and articles, which is the editor's picks. I didn't find those very interesting, so I've turned that one off. The last option in this section is about updates from your groups. I like group discussions, but I find that notifications are very wishy-washy, so I have turned mine on, but they don't always actually send me notifications. Still, if you get involved in groups, then I would leave these on. Okay, so that's all of the push notifications done. So those are the notifications that you're seeing from your phone desktop, whether the app lights up or not. But But the last section is about on LinkedIn, which is the notifications you see once you're inside the app. So these are slightly different. So we start here by tapping View Settings. So the first section here is Activity in your network. I'm not bothered about any of these things apart from engagement. So that's the top one selected, Activity from your connections. If you scroll down, there's also an option at the very bottom for your new followers. When you're getting started, you might want to know about new followers. So they're not the same as connections. They're just people who are, they're kind of subscribed to see your content, but they're not directly connected with you. So they can't send you a direct message, for example. But after a while, if you start having a popular profile, you'll get a lot of followers. And I don't think you get a lot of value out of that. So I've turned that feature off. The only one I've got is that top one, Activity from your connections. Okay, the next section is activity that involves you. I'm more interested in the things in here too. Starting with analytics on your posts, I think this is a pointless thing if you've got popular posts. You'll get a notification if you reach 50 views and then 100 views. And most of my posts get hundreds or sometimes even thousands of views, so I don't find that useful, so I've turned that off. I'm not quite sure about confirmation of your post, because I don't ever see that when I post something, it actually sends me a notification to say, you've posted something. So I think that one's a bit dubious, but I've left that on anyway. Conversations that mention you, that one's important. So if someone tags you, so they type the at symbol and then your name and it turns your name blue, you want to be notified about tags, so I definitely would leave that on. Responses to your activity, so if someone's responding to your likes and comments, you want to know about that. If you post up job updates, I would say also that you want to know about that. I used to have skill endorsements notifications turned on. Although they're very nice, I'm not particularly bothered about seeing when someone endorses me for a skill. So I've turned that off. When I upload videos, I don't really need to know when someone, when the video's uploaded properly. So I've turned that off, and who's viewed my profile too. Not too fussed about that either. Okay, so the next one is invitations and messages, which sounds more interesting than it is because it's all about careers advice and matches and so forth. Don't care about any of those, so I've turned all of those things off. Almost done now. Jobs and opportunities is about recommendations for work. I'm not looking for work in an employed position, so I'm not particularly bothered by this, and I've turned those off. News and articles just contains the daily rundown, which is some sort of LinkedIn summary about what it thinks you'll like. Totally pointless, I think, so I've turned that off. And the last section is called updates from your groups. And again, you can request notifications inside the app for group discussions and responses to your posts. Again, as I said earlier, they don't always work as expected, but do turn them on if you contribute to groups. Otherwise, you've got no chance of seeing those updates. Okay, so that's it. A quick look at the notification settings in the LinkedIn mobile app. Now, LinkedIn do tend to change these quite often. So you might find by the time you come to look at this that there are more or sometimes even fewer options. If you get confused, by all means, drop me a line and I'll do my best to try and explain how it all works. But I hope this has helped, and I'll speak to you again soon. Take care.